So, good afternoon, guys. So, I think this topic is left. So, first of all, we will cover this topic, controlling VTY axis. What do you mean by controlling VTY axis? Let me explain this thing to you first, then we will come on the walk. Now, this is my router. Fine. Just think like it is connected to another router, and here I have a LAN. This is one more router. This is one more switch. This thing is clear. Now, this router is having how many IPs? 1, 2, 3. Let's say 1, 2, 3. If you want to remotely access this router through Telnet or through SSH, you can use any of the IP. 1, 2 or 3. Yes or no? Yes. Now, here I have users X, Y, Z, P, Q, R. These are my users. Now guys, what you can do is, you can control access of VTY lines. You can What do you mean by this particular thing? That I can control that which user will get a VTY line and which user will not get. So what I will do on R2, I will configure a standard ACL. All of you know standard ACL is a source based. What we configure in or what we specify in standard ACL? Source. So like this, I am writing here permit P, permit Z, permit Y. After that, deny any. If I don't write deny any, it will be by default deny any. This is a standard ACL, yes or no? Now I will call this standard ACL in my VTY lines. Line VTY 0 to 4. How many VTY lines I have created? 5. I will write here access class ACL number. Let's say ACL number is 10. Direction will be in. मुझे जितना याद आ रहा है मैंने ये डिस्कस किया था, क्योंकि मैंने आपको बताया था यहाँ पे इन और आउट का मतलब. मेरे को जितना याद आ रहा है मैंने क्लास में डिस्कस किया था, क्योंकि मुझे जितना याद है मेरे से किसी ने पूछा था सर ये इन और आउट का मतलब क्या होता है यहाँ पे. इन मींस हाउ मेनी यूजर्स कैन टेलनेट दिस पर्टिकुलर राउटर. नाउ व्हेन यू हैव टेलनेट, हाउ मेनी यूजर्स कैन गो आउट फ्रॉम हेयर, गो आउट फ्रॉम हेयर. दिस थिंग इज क्लियर. सो डायरेक्शन विल बी इन. What do you mean by this thing? That whenever a user will come to the router and user will say, I want a line. Which line? VTY line. It means he is accessing the router through SSH or through Telnet. He want a line. This time router will check the ACL. If the user is permitted in the ACL, only then a line is given to the user. If user is not permitted in the ACL, line is never provided to the user. It means what we are doing, we are controlling access of which lines? Of VTY lines. This thing is clear. Ab aapka paragraph padh lete hain. Now we will read his problem. Should I read?
Sir, isme access list banane ke baad interface ke upar access group ke tarah entry karne ki zarurat
nahi. Where I am calling my access list? In the line VTY mode. Fine? Okay. Read this paragraph. I am reading. Don't give up. There always a. Yaar, shuru se hi padhte hain. Aise kya samajh mein aayega? Trying to stop users from. Yaar, aap padho. Main nahi padh raha. Padho na, saare milke. Now, first of all, he is telling you the reason why he is not putting the ACL or why he is not configuring the ACL on the interface. First of all, try to understand this thing. He is not doing so because if I have to telnet this router, I can telnet using this interface also, this also, and it means I have to configure ACL on three interfaces. Instead of configuring ACL on three interfaces, he is providing you the solution. He is providing you the, that's why we are configuring your ACL on line mode. This thing is clear? Now, next line. पढ़ लिया पहला पैराग्राफ, कोई इशू किसी को, कोई बात ना समझ में आई हो? सी व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय लेटेंसी हियर, ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड. इफ दिस इज अ राउटर, you are configuring ACL in which direction? Yes or no? Every traffic which will pass through this interface will be checked, which will cause a latency, and your network performance will be dragged down. Will be dragged down. Drag ka matlab hota hai khichna. Performance network ki kya hogi? Drag down. फाइन. और उससे क्या कॉज होगी? दैट विल कॉज लेटेंसी. ये कहना चाहता है यहाँ पे.
टाइम इट टेक्स फॉर स्पेसिफिक ब्लॉक ऑफ डेटा ऑन अ डेटा ट्रैक टू रोटेट अराउंड.
नहीं, he is not explaining latency here. He is explaining rotational latency. हाँ जी. Latency का मतलब होता है time. वैसे यार delay होता है वो time.
Disturbance.
Latency का मतलब. मेरे हिसाब से तो why is saying latency here? Because every traffic which is passed through the interface will be checked, and that thing will cause latency in a big network. जो मुझे समझ में आ रहा है. Fine, you can read it again. दोबारा पढ़ लो क्या लिखा हुआ. Really won't scale well if you happen to have dozen even hundred of interfaces. Now would it? And think of the latency dragging down your network as a result of each and every router checking every packet just in case the packet was trying to access the BTY lines. Horrible. Packet you are sending, packet is a transit packet, router will check that packet also. This thing is clear? Now, don't give up. There always is a solution, and in this case a much better one, which employs a standard IP access solution to control the access to the lines themselves. Fine. Next thing. Why does this work so well? Because when you apply ACL to the VTY, you don't need to specify the protocol, since access to the VTY already implies terminal access via telnet, or because router already knows that VTY lines are used to provide access to which protocols? Telnet and SSH. You also don't need to specify a destination address because it really doesn't matter which interface address the user need as a target for the. All you really need to control of is where the user is coming from and which is betrayed by their source IP. ठीक है जी. You need to do these two things to make this happen. Create a standard ACL and apply this using access class command. You can do it. It's practical on your own. There will be no issues. Fine. कोई problem इसमें? And always keep one thing in mind, that whenever you are using this particular thing, or if I talk about real time, in real time on router you will always configure SSH. You will now never configure telnet. So we need access list every time. Yes, even in SSH also, because it is controlling the access of VTY lines. It is not about username and password. It is about who is permitted and who is denied. ICMP.
ICMP
echo is for echo request. ICMP echo reply is for echo reply. ICMP echo. If you are trying to block the reply, then it will be echo reply. Echo means echo request. Fine. This is our chapter of WAN. Fine. So first topic, defining WAN terms. Read these all terms at your place. We don't have much time here. Fine. There is no need to read these terms. Fine. WAN, connection time. Leave these terms. If you want to read, you only use, you can read Lee's lines, because circuit switching, packet switching are not used nowadays. Fine. Here you can read about frame relay, you can read about ISDN if you want to, otherwise leave it. You can read about HDLC, PPP, PPPoE. You can leave all other things, no issues. You can read about MPLS if you want to read. Fine. Leave this topic, cable and DSL. Fine. Leave this topic, digital subscriber line, what it is. ADSL, leave this topic. There is no need to read. Leave PPPoE. We will discuss it in CCNP. LRE, leave it. Cabling the serial wide, serial transmission. Leave all this stuff. DT, DC. Leave all this stuff. There is no need to read. Now, start with HDLs. You have to start this chapter from leave all other stuff. Fine. If you will read that stuff, that will just fuck your brain. Some neurons will die. Yes. Fine. So, पढ़ना शुरू करें? कौन पढ़ेगा? आपसे स्टार्ट हो जाओ. एक-एक पैरा पढ़ना, अपने नंबर से पढ़ते जाना. बैठ के आराम से. मजाक नहीं करेंगे. Yes. What is trying to say? First of all, let me explain the stuff. What is trying to say that HDLC is first of all a layer 2 encapsulation by default present on serial links. Any issues? Any problem? Now he is saying that it will provide you on this particular link. See, first of all, what is frame synchronization? Yes? छोड़ो उस बात को. Frame synchronization means if I am sending 10 frames from here, 10 are received here. Fine. And what do you mean by FCS? That in between there is no change in my data. All of you know the meaning of FCS, frame check sequence. That whenever from a serial end a router is sending some data, it will calculate FCS. On the same data, other router will also calculate FCS. If it will match, only then it will accept. And the last line is saying that HDLC cannot provide authentication on this particular link. Why we need authentication? First question is this. Okay guys, for some time, take an example. Fine. Like you have a company. You have a company. You have to take connection from ISP. If I go 5 to 7 years back, if you want a WAN service, what kind of cable you were using for WAN service? You were using serial cables. You were using? Serial. It means ISP will provide you a serial cable at your end. Yes or no? Just think like, I am ISP, I am providing you a serial cable, and I am providing him also a serial cable. Now, after 1 month, I am saying your bill is 30,000. You have access internet, or you have access 100 GB of internet, and your bill is 30,000. He is saying, I have not run internet. I have not accessed even Google for a single time. Why should I pay the bill? Just try to understand what was going on. That I have provided him a serial cable. In between, what he has done? Just said, tanga nahi laga lete tar mein. He has connected his wire and he has connected the same serial cable to his router. Now actually, who is connected? Sagar, who is using the internet? Sagar. Now there is a problem. That how I will get to know that the customer is valid or not? It means if I will use a serial link and I will use HDLC as encapsulation, I cannot, I will never get to know customer is authenticated or not. It means HDLC will never support authentication. Is clear? कभी भी HDLC पता नहीं लगा सकता कि सामने वाला end authenticated है या नहीं. जैसे आपने फोन का कनेक्शन लिया है, किसका? फोन का. आपकी तार घर पे आ रही थी, मैंने बीच में से तार ब्रेक करके अपने घर पे तार लगा ली. कर सकता हूँ मैं ऐसा? अब जितनी कॉल्स मैं करूंगा बिल कौन भरेगा? आप भरोगे? लोग ऐसा करते थे. पीपल वर डूइंग द सेम थिंग. लाइक मेरी कॉलोनी में तो मैंने ऐसे किया हुआ. मैंने क्या किया, मेरे नीचे वालों के घर पे ब्रॉडबैंड कनेक्शन लगा हुआ. देखो वो 10 बजे सो जाते थे, उसके बाद ब्रॉडबैंड का यूज करता था. उन्होंने गलती कह दी. लाइक मैं पहले सिविल हॉस्पिटल, मेरे मम्मा जॉब करते हैं, तो मैं वहां रहता था. मेरा घर ऊपर था, उनका घर नीचे था. मेरी विंडो से ही बाहर अंदर आती थी मेरी. वो मैंने बिल नहीं भरा, मेरे पापा ने बिल नहीं भरा. क्यों नहीं भरा आपको पता? मैं क्या करता पापा भरा गया घर पर? अरे गेम खेलता था, कुछ ऐसा गलत नहीं करता था. फाइन, मैं गेम खेलता था, उनका सही सारा दिन बैठ के पढ़ता नहीं था बिल्कुल भी. तो पापा ने इंटरनेट का बिल नहीं भरा. तो मैंने कहा कि वो डब्बी लगी हुई थी, फिर वाज अ बॉक्स. वन वायर वाज कमिंग टू माय हाउस, वन वायर वाज गोइंग इन देयर हाउस. मेरा कनेक्शन तो क्या था पता हुआ? मैंने उसकी वायर में किया, पंखा लगाया, जोड़ी, अपना इंटरनेट सारी रात मैं मत चलाता था. और सुबह डब्बे में वो वायर
वापस उनकी
लगाया
था, तो एक तरह की क्या थी चोरी। लेकिन इसमें मेरे को एक शरणपत्ति और करनी पड़ी। मैं उस भाई के घर गया, मैं उसका यूजर नेम और पासवर्ड भी देख के आया, वरना मैं इंटरनेट कभी भी, बिकॉज नाउ अडेज वेन यू आर यूजिंग इंटरनेट एक्चुअली फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल यू हैव टू ऑथेंटिकेट यूर सेल्फ टू द आईएसपी दैट यू आर द करेक्ट कस्टमर हु इज टेकिंग द एक्सेस। उनके बच्चे छोटे छोटे थे, मैं थोड़ा बड़ा था उम्र में, ठीक है जी।
सो दिस इज द थिंग, मेरे को आपको ऑथेंटिकेशन का मतलब समझाना था, आपको समझ में आ गया दैट हाउ आईएसपी विल चेक दैट यू आर ऑथेंटिकेटेड यूजर और नॉट। इट मींस बाय डिफॉल्ट एचडीएलसी विल नेवर प्रोवाइड यू ऑथेंटिकेशन। नेक्स्ट थिंग, यस बारी आपकी।
इन बाइंड ओरिएंटेड प्रोटोकॉल्स कंट्रोल इंफॉर्मेशन इज एनकोडेड यूजिंग एंटायर बाइट्स, ऑन द अदर हैंड बिट ओरिएंटेड प्रोटोकॉल्स यूज सिंगल बिट्स टू रिप्रेजेंट द कंट्रोल इंफॉर्मेशन। सम कॉमन बिट ओरिएंटेड प्रोटोकॉल्स आर एचडीएलसी एंड एचडीएलसी टीसीपी एंड आईपीआर बाइट ओरिएंटेड प्रोटोकॉल्स।
नाउ व्हाट आर बिट ओरिएंटेड प्रोटोकॉल एंड व्हाट आर बाइट ओरिएंटेड प्रोटोकॉल्स, रीड दिस पैराग्राफ वंस अगेन। Yes. Read this paragraph once again, तभी समझ में आएगा, पढ़ो।
In byte-oriented protocols, control information is encoded using entire bytes. On the other hand, bit-oriented protocols are using protocol use single bits to represent the control information. Some common bit-oriented protocols are SDLC and HDLC, TCP and IP are byte-oriented protocols.
Okay. Guys, what is the difference between bit and byte? One byte is equal to whenever TCP and UDP traffic will travel, or whenever traffic will travel, or whenever these protocols are used, information is binded in bytes, control information, fine. But if I talk about HDLC, control information is present in form of bits, never in form of bytes. This is what he is trying to say. Next paragraph.
Control information.
बात करेंगे. 2 मिनट रुक जाओ. Header आएगा भी HDLC का आगे. आएगा. Yes.
HDLC is the default encapsulation used by Cisco routers over synchronous serial links.
Now, when he is saying over synchronous serial links, what do you mean by synchronous? Guys, all of you remember one thing. That whenever we define or we connect routers through a serial link.
Hello, good morning. Please have a seat. Please have a seat.
Okay. Fine. Padho bhai. Kiski bari thi?
And Cisco's HDLC is proprietary.
Bro, we were discussing this thing. Cisco HDLC is the default encapsulation by Cisco routers over synchronous serial links. Second line.
And Cisco's HDLC is proprietary, meaning it won't communicate with any other vendor's HDLC implementation.
It means now one thing is clear, Cisco is having a different HDLC and other vendors, if they are using HDLC, is different. In the line, he is trying to say Cisco HDLC is different and other vendor HDLC is different. How it is different, after some time you will get to. Fine. Now, I want to explain the meaning of. What do you mean by synchronization? Synchronous means they are synchronized, yes or no? What do you mean by synchronized? We need to define a clock rate. Without clock rate, serial link will never get synchronized. And nowadays, the serial interfaces you are using have by default a clock rate of 2 lakhs. Have by default a clock rate of 2 lakhs. So that link will automatically get synchronized. यार मेरे को नहीं पता, आपकी बुक में नहीं दिए हुए वो पैरामीटर, और वो पैरामीटर पता भी नहीं होने चाहिए। व्हाट आई एम ट्राइंग टू से, इफ एट वन एंड लेट्स से आई एम यू आर डीटी आई एम डीसी, ऑल ऑफ यू नो दैट सीरियल केबल हैव टू एंड्स, वन इज डीटी वन इज डीसी। डीटी मींस डेटा टर्मिनल, डीसी मींस डेटा कम्युनिकेशन। यू ऑलवेज असाइन क्लॉक रेट एट डीसी एंड। फाइन, नाउ आई एम अ डीसी एंड. If clock rate is not defined, then I will send you a HDLC frame. I will never mark or I will never send clock rate in it, yes or no? It means the link will never come up. Protocol will remain because link will never be synchronized. Link will be synchronized with the help of clock rate. Next slide, next paragraph.
But don't give Cisco grief for it. Everyone's HDLC implementation is proprietary.
What is trying to say? Everyone HDLC implementation is proprietary. It means if I am having a Juniper router and if I am having a Cisco router, I cannot run HDLC encapsulation between them. Why? Because Juniper is using its own HDLC, Cisco is using its own HDLC. This thing is clear? Next thing.
The reason every vendor has a proprietary HDLC encapsulation hardware is that each vendor has a different way for an HDLC protocol to encapsulate multiple network layer protocols.
Next slide.
If the vendors didn't have a way for HDLC to communicate the different layer free protocols, then HDLC would be able to operate in only a single layer 3 protocol environment. This proprietary header is placed in the data field of the
HDLC encapsulation. What he is trying to say, like all of you know about Ethernet header. In Ethernet header we have a type field. What is the useful type field? What protocol we are using at layer 3? Yes or no? Or above layer 2? Which protocol we are using? This is the use of type field. Now what he is saying, that every HDLC header has a different, or you can say variation in type field, have variations in. Now there can be a chance that Juniper HDLC header is just supporting IP, is just supporting IP at layer 3, but Cisco's HDLC header is supporting IP also, IPv6 also. Agree or not? So there will be variation in the type field. So there can be a chance that HDLC is supporting multiple layer 3 protocols, and there can be a chance HDLC is supporting only a one single layer 3 protocol. That's why it is never compatible. That's why it is never. Now, next thing. Now, it is Cisco HDLC. In Cisco HDLC, what we have? Read this line. It means if between two Cisco routers, what is saying? I was saying if I am having two routers, fine, and the, both routers are Cisco routers, which encapsulation I will be running between them by default? They will support multiple layer 3 protocols, because which field we have? Proprietary field is here working as the type field, as a type field. But in case of normal HDLC, we don't have a proprietary field. It means normal protocols, or if I have two Juniper routers, they will only support which protocol? IP. They will never support IPv6, because there is no proprietary field in case of Juniper. This thing is clear. तभी मैंने पहले ऐसा कहा था कि जो different vendors के HDLC है वो कितने layer 3 protocol support करता है? सिर्फ एक. लेकिन Cisco का कितने support करता है?
Multiple.
This thing is clear? Now, read this paragraph fast. Bhai, kahin isne bataya wo wali bit ke bare mein, iske bare mein aap pooch rahe the. In the beginning. Aap to apna question bhi bhul jate ho. Control bits ke bare mein. Control information ke bare mein. Isne sirf hug diya hai yahan. Haan. Yaar dekho, jab ek author book likh raha hota, author ko dikhana hota, usse aata hai. To wo kuch terms aise use karta, samne wale ko samajh mein. नहीं आती। अब मैं क्यों समझाऊं किसी को जब बुक में इंफॉर्मेशन दी नहीं, मैं पहले पढ़ चुका था वैसे, ठीक है। हाँ जी, ये वाला पैराग्राफ पढ़ो जो इम्पोर्टेंट है, फटाफट पढ़ो सब लोग फटाफट। इन दिस केस वी विल यूज ओके, हु विल रीड अबाउट पीपीपी? पढ़ो शुभम फटाफट यार फटाफट।
पॉइंट टू पॉइंट प्रोटोकॉल इज अ डाटा लिंक लेयर प्रोटोकॉल दैट कैन बी यूज्ड ओवर आइदर असिंक्रोनस सीरियल डायल अप और सिंक्रोनस सीरियल ISDN
मीडिया। He is trying to say that it will, you can use it for ISDN connections also and dial-up media also. Now what is ISDN, what is dial-up, leave it. It's not your part to understand. Fine. But you must know that it can work on synchronous media also and it can work on asynchronous media also. Fine. Next thing. मैं पढ़ता हूँ। It relies on link LCP to build and maintain data link connections. NCP enables multiple network layer protocols to be used on point-to-point connection. Now, PPP works on actually two protocols, NCP and LCP. NCP stands for Network Control Protocol. LCP stands for Link Control Protocol. What is the use of LCP? LCP is used to set up a connection between two devices. And NCP is used to define which layer 3 protocol you are using. Which layer 3 protocol you are whether it is IP or it is IPv6 or it is any other layer 3 protocol. This thing is clear? Any issues? No. We will discuss that how LCP will establish the connection. Let me discuss this, read this paragraph. Yes, you can read about LCP here. Yes. A method of establishing, configuring, maintaining and the point to point. It also provides features such as authentication. Next thing. See, first of all HDLC. Either I can use HDLC or I can use LCP. See, LCP is just used to maintain the connection or establish the connection. How connection is established, we will discuss that thing. Wait for some time. But after that, what is the use of NCP? Specific to. It means what layer 3 protocol you are going to use is specified by which protocol in PPP? NCP. Network Control Protocol. Okay. A method of establishing and configuring different network layer protocols for transport across the NCP is designed to allow simultaneously use of multiple network layer protocols. Two examples of protocols here are IPCP and we will discuss about IPCP and CDPCP. Wait. Yes. Read this line. PPP session establishment is divided into three phases. First is, second is, third is, now. Yes. Read the first paragraph. Sagar.
LCP packets are sent by 8 PPP devices to configure and attach the link. These packets contain a field called configuration option that allows each device to see the size of the data, the compression and authentication. If no configuration option field is present, then the default configurations will be used.
Next phase.
Authentication phase. If required, either SAC or PAC can be used to authenticate a link. Authentication takes place before the network layer protocol information is read. And it's also possible that link quality determination will also occur simultaneously.
Next thing.
Network layer protocol phase. PPP uses the network control protocol to allow multiple network layer protocols to be encapsulated and sent over a PPP data link. Each network layer protocol establishes service with NCP.
look here, this is R1, this is R2. Fine. First of all, which phase is there? Connection establishment phase. What will happen? Actually, on this link, first of all, this router will send, or this router will tell R2. What size of data? It means MTU. Fine. First of all, R1 will tell R2 about its interface MTU. Second thing, compression if used. If R1 is using any compression mechanism, what are compression mechanism? There are some ways that on serial links, what you can do? You can compress your data. That thing is not in our syllabus. But what I am trying to tell you, that R1 will ask R2, I am using this compression mechanism, are you using the same? If they are using the same, only then compression thing will be fine. Otherwise link will never come up. This thing is clear. Third thing, what authentication you are using? What authentication you are using? Now, R2 will also tell the same things to R1. Fine. This thing is clear. This is the working of LCP, link control protocol. Now, if these three things are fine, a LCP connection is established. What is established? LCP connection. This thing is fine. Now, after that, they will tell each other what network control protocols are allowed. What I am trying to say, these things will be predefined. Predefined like, when R1 will send IP traffic to R2, R1 will put the information of IP in which protocol?
LCP.
When R1 will send IPv6 traffic to R2, which protocol, in which protocol it will send the information? In NCP. This thing is fine. Now, how authentication takes place between R1 and R2? First of all, between R1 and R2, one will act as PPP server, other will act as PPP client. Now, again I am back on the same example, just think like I am ISP and these are my customers. Who will authenticate? They will authenticate. To whom they will authenticate? To me. It means I will act as PPP and they will act as PPP client. They will act as PPP client. This thing is clear. Now, if they are acting as PPP client, they always send me their username and password, and what I will do? I will match those username and password with my database. If they will match, I will provide them access. If it will not match, I will not provide them access. This thing is clear. This thing is fine. So, PPP server configuration is different and PPP client configuration is different. In PPP, two types of authentication are supported. At this time, authentication is negotiated by which protocol? LCP. Two types of authentication are there, PAP and CHAMP. We have other types of authentication also, but that are not in your syllabus. Now, what is PAP? What is CHAMP? Just learn about it. PAP means password authentication protocol. Whenever R1, like they are clients, whenever they will send me username and password, they will send me clean text. So if Sagar is an intruder, or Sagar is planning for a man in the middle attack, Sagar can capture username and password. But in case of CHAP, what is CHAP? Channel handshake. Oh sorry, challenge handshake authentication protocol. In case of CHAP, all things will be encrypted. This thing is clear. So this is the main difference between CHAP and PAP. Either you can set authentication to CHAP or you can set authentication to PAP. This thing is clear. Always keep one thing in mind, that clients or customers always act as PPP client and ISP always act as PPP server. On the server, what thing you have to maintain? Database. And client will always send username and password. This thing is clear? Now you can read this thing from your books, there will be no issue. This example is actually wrong. What is IPCP and what is CDPCP? We have to discuss about these things also. NCP, by default two protocols are used. One is IPCP, stands for Internet Protocol Control Protocol. What is the use or what is the feature provided by this IPCP protocol? That after connection establishment, after connection established by LCP, R1 will tell its own interface IP to R2, and R2 will install that IP address in its routing table. In its R2 will tell its own interface IP to R1, and R1 will install that IP address in the routing table. It means if on R1 and R2 you are using IPs of different network, you are using IPs of different network, they can ping each other. They can, let's say on R1 you are using network AIP, on R2 you are using network, by default they will, you cannot ping each other. Yes or no? Yes. The thing is clear without using routing, without using. But in this case, as you run PPP over this link, there will be a protocol called IPCP that will be working. R2 will tell about its IP to A, R1 will install this IP also in its routing table, R2 will also install this IP in its routing table. So if we are using different IPs on both the ends, they will still communicate. They will still, there will be no issue. This thing is clear? Any problem? I can disable this feature also, and real time it is mostly disabled. In real time it is mostly disabled. Second thing is CDPCP. CDP, Cisco Discovery Protocol Control Protocol. Now, as connection is established, now R1 will send its CDP information to R2, and R2 will send its CDP information to R1. They will not use normal CDP, they will use CDP. This thing is clear? And bhai kyun PPP kya ek open standard protocol, CDP CP is used by every other protocol. This thing is clear? Sorry, every other vendor. Let me read this thing. Okay, we will read it from the very beginning. Start. हाँ भाई पढ़ना शुरू करो फटाफट.
CDPCP was one of the most popular WAN services deployed over the past two decades, and there is a good reason for this cost. And it's a rare network design or designer that has the privilege to ignore that all important cost factor. By default, frame relays are classified as a non-broadcast multi-access NBMA network, meaning it doesn't send any broadcast such as RIP updates across the network.
Okay, now you have a first point for frame relay, that frame relay is classified as a non-broadcast network. On this network, by default, broadcasts are not allowed. It means if you are using here R1, R2, they are connected via frame relay and you are running RIP, R1 will never able to send update to R2. By default, broadcast and multicast is not allowed. But I am trying to say, if this is R1, R1 is connected to R2 and you are running here with service, frame relay. On this link, broadcast and multicast will not be broadcast plus multicast. Not allowed. Any problem? Yes. Leave this thing. See, here is defining the reason that why we need frame relay. Okay, I will tell you the reason. यार ये पढ़ना है आपको, आप घर जाके पढ़ लोगे इसको पक्का? ठीक है, मैं आपको फ्रेम रिले समझा रहा हूँ अब सारा, ध्यान तो सुनो। What was happening in the past before frame relay? Fine, we were using dedicated lease lines. What was the problem? Just think like I have a site in Mumbai. Fine. You want to connect it to Delhi. You have to use a lease line. Agree? You want to connect it to, let's say this is Delhi. You want to connect it to Bangalore. You have to use another lease line. You have to connect it to Chennai. You have to use one more. In this case, how many lease line connections you have to take? Three. But in case of frame relay, what you can do? You can take a single connection, and by using that single connection, you can reach multiple sites. You can reach how? In this case, bandwidth will remain fixed. Guys, what is the use of lease line? Lease line means I am having my own path. I am having my own path. Own path is like I have for network bulls, I have a lease line of 10 Mbps. It means ISP is saying that you will get 10 Mbps always. You are using it or not. Your 10 Mbps are reserved for you. Your 10 Mbps are reserved for you. This thing is clear? This thing is fine. It means you will always get a speed of never less than 10 Mbps. This thing is clear. Now in this case, if every lease line is of 10 Mbps, R1 will get how much speed? 30 Mbps. He has to pay for how many lease lines? 3, and he has to pay for 30 Mbps. Even though he is not using, he has to pay. This is the main thing of lease line. Like I have a lease line of 10 Mbps, price is fixed. I can use unlimited upload and download, but speed will always remain 10 Mbps. I can upload and download unlimited, but I have to pay for 10 Mbps. Price for 10 Mbps is like 1,60,000 per year for 10 Mbps. Fine. Now, what benefit frame relay has provided me? Just think like this is frame relay. Frame relay is actually a service that you are getting from the service provider. Like you have sites, one in Delhi, one in Bangalore, other one in Chennai, and this is Gurgaon. First of all, this time how many links you need? Only one? Yes or no? Just think like this is 10 Mbps. He has also taken a connection of 10 Mbps, he has also taken a connection of 10 Mbps, he has also taken a connection of 10 Mbps. First thing, frame relay, you can only run frame relay on which links? Which links? Serial links. Now, minimum bandwidth provided by serial links is 1.54 Mbps and maximum bandwidth provided by serial links is 45 Mbps. This thing is clear? The serial links you are having in labs are of 1.54 Mbps, but in real time, if I am using a serial link, bandwidth of that serial link is 45 Mbps. Now, first of all, how many lines I have to take? Only one line. And second benefit, I have to pay for the data that I will upload and download. I will not get something unlimited. This thing is clear. Now, if frame relay is provided me a connection of 10 Mbps, he will not always provide me 10 Mbps. This is the first thing. What he will say, that there is something called CIR. CIR means committed information rate. That I will provide you a minimum speed all the time, let's say 7 Mbps. All the time I will provide you a 7 Mbps speed, but I cannot guarantee that I will provide you 10 Mbps. But there is a chance. If my service is not used by many users, if my service is not used by many, you can use their bandwidth. You can use? It means when network is free, you can use more than 10 Mbps. But I cannot guarantee that I will provide you 10 Mbps. Every time. मैं तुम्हें हमेशा 10 Mbps दे पाऊंगा ये पॉसिबल नहीं, लेकिन 7 Mbps की मैं कह देता हूँ गारंटी। मैं तुम्हें 10 Mbps से ज्यादा स्पीड भी दे दूंगा अगर मेरे नेटवर्क पर यूजर क्या होंगे, कम होंगे। क्योंकि why he is saying so? Because frame relay is a shared medium. Frame relay is a it is working here like a switch. Okay. If I go to the previous case, in this case, how many subnets I have to purchase? Public IPs. Three subnets? In this case, I can use a single subnet. It means that will save my IPs also. Yes or no? So this particular thing is called 0.2 point, and this particular thing is called 0.2 multipoint. Yes, I am connecting Gurgaon to Delhi, Bangalore, Chennai. 0.2 multipoint. I am using the same path. If I want to reach Gurgaon, if I want to reach Chennai, if I want to reach Bangalore. This thing is clear. So now, let me discuss some more terms related to frame relay. Frame relay is actually a layer 2 encapsulation. You can run it on which links? Serial links. Next thing, FRS means frame relay switch. Frame relay switch is nothing but a router on which routing is disabled and it is acting as a frame relay switch. See, what is going inside this ISP? This is not our concern. We must know what is going between ISP and us or between our sites. This thing is clear? So let's say this is R1. And let's say this is a simple switch. If R1 want to reach R2, what R1 will do? R1 will generate a R. Yes or no? By default, if R1 want to reach R2, R2 knows about destination IP, what R1 will do? R1 will generate R. It means switch will forward information on the basis of MAC address, yes or no? But on serial links, there is no MAC address. There is no MAC address. So what information I will use at layer 2? I will use DLCI. I will use DLCI stands for Data Link Control Identifier. Data Link Control. Now try to understand the main thing. I am a switch, all of you are users. Or think like I am a switch, all of you are sites. If you want to reach him, what you will do? You know his destination IP. For destination IP, you will generate an ARP. ARP is received by me, I will broadcast. This is the process which is going on when all of you are connected through a switch. Just think like this time I am a frameless service provider. Now, at layer 2, which information you are using? At layer 2, which information are you are using? DLCI is. Which information you are using? DLCI stands for? Data Link Control. Now guys, listen to me carefully. In case of ARP, we have to find destination MAC address using destination IP address. But in this case, you must know what is your local DELCI to reach the particular destination IP. What is your local DELCI? What I am saying, what I am trying to say, let's say this is R1, this is FRS. FRS means switch or frame relay service provider. This is R2. R1 must know, just think like here IP is 10.0.0.1, here IP is 10.0.0.2. R1 must know which DELCI. DELCI is a number. DELCI is just a number which must be greater than 60. Now why it must be greater than 616? It is a predefined thing. You cannot change it. Fine. So let's say I am using a DELCI 102. Now R1 must know that it must use DELCI 102 to reach R2. Now this thing is creating a path. This thing is creating a path from R1 to R2. This path is called PVC. This path is called permanent virtual circuit. Now what FRS will do? FRS, like switch is building a MAC address table, FRS will build a switching table, like interface number 1, interface number 2. Interface number 1, we have a DELCI 102. Clear? Interface number 2, we have DELCI 201. Switch traffic from 102 to 201. See, whenever 102 will send traffic, this guy will never read my IPs because it is using which layer information? Layer 2. Switch cannot read layer 3 information. In the same way, frame relay switch cannot read layer 3 information. This thing is fine. Now look here. This guy will say information is coming from which DELCI? I have to switch it to 201. And by this, one thing is very clear, that PVC is always unidirectional. PVC is always unidirectional. It means if you want to come back from R2 to R1, you have to define. You have to tell R2 that if you want to reach R1, you have to use the DELCI 201. It means for a bi-directional connection, how many DELCIs you need? How many DELCIs you need? 2. And frame relay switch will forward information on the basis of DELCI. This thing is clear? Any doubt, any problem? To anybody?
Sir, actually R3 suppose under hota, so 103 use karega ki uske liye
alag hai. R1 FRS, R2, R3. Now, R1 will say, I will use DELCI 102 to go to, and I will use DELCI 103 to go to R3. R2 will say, I will use 201 to move to R3. R3 will say, I will use 301 to move to R1. How many sites are directly connected? 2, R1 to R2, R1 to R3. How many DELCs you need? 4. This thing is clear? Because one DELC will provide you a unidirectional path. And how this guy will switch information, you want to know? Like this. Switch 1022 201, switch 1032 301. When information is coming from 102, to which interface which it will switch the information? The interface which is associated with 201, yes or no? And if information is arriving from 103, it will switch information on the interface which is assigned to 301. Why? On the same thing I am coming now, that on a single interface we can assign multiple DELCs, but vice versa is not possible. Vice versa is? What do you mean by vice versa? That you cannot assign same DELC to multiple interfaces. Why? It will confuse frame delay switch. It will confuse? Yes, how frame delay switch will switch the traffic then? Fine? What I am trying to say? यार लोकली आपको लगता है स्विचिंग किसके बेस पे हो रही है? डेलसी के बेस
पे.
डेलसी यू हैव टू परचेज डेलसी फ्रॉम हूम? फ्रॉम सर्विस
प्रोवाइडर.
भाई फिर वही बात तू कर रहा है. ये R1 है भाई, ये बीच में पापा भी तो है सबके. Fine. R1 knows, let's say here we have IP 10.0.0.1, here we have IP 10.0.0.2. Now you are saying he is using 102 and he is also using 102. Let's say he is 10.0.0.3. According to you, he can also use 102. मैं यही बात कह रहा था ना स्टार्टिंग से, दैट यू कैन नॉट यूज सेम आईपी फॉर सॉरी सेम डेलसी फॉर मल्टीपल इंटरफेसेस. यू कैन नॉट यूज सेम डेलसी फॉर मल्टीपल इंटरफेसेस एंड आई एम स्टिल सेइंग द सेम थिंग. व्हाट विल बी द इशू? जस्ट थिंक लाइक दिस इज अ राउटर. राउटर इज हैविंग हाउ मेनी इंटरफेसेस? 1 2 3. फॉर वन इंटरफेस, फर्स्ट इंटरफेस व्हिच डेलसी यू हैव डिफाइंड? फॉर इंटरफेस नंबर 2. For interface number 3. Now what will be the mapping? You have connected it like this. Connect 1 2 2. It means you have mapped the DELC like this. Yes or no? Connect 1 2 3. 1 0 2 2 again. How it will get to know when a traffic is coming from 1? It has to send here or it has to send here. So this is the case that you cannot define same DELC to multiple interfaces. This thing is clear. In this case, this guy will be confused.
Sir,
पहले वाला
लेकिन
हाँ, we have to define a different DELC.
मतलब 201 और 201.
नहीं. Fine. We can define a different DELC. This thing is fine. R3 can reach R2 via R1. R3 can reach R1, sorry, R2 via
R1.
You have to define a new mapping. This thing is clear?
Which protocol is used for DLC mapping?
We are coming on that thing, bro.
Sir, directly
PVC, you have to create a different PVC. Like from R2 to R3 you are defining a DELC 104, and from R3 to R2 you are defining a DELC 40. This thing is clear? Read this paragraph first of all. Do it fast.
Unless you have a
By default, frame rule encapsulation is of two types. One is Cisco, one is IETF. When you are connecting two Cisco devices together, by default you have to use encapsulation Cisco. But if you are connecting a Cisco device with a non-Cisco device and you are running frame relay between them, you have to run which encapsulation? IETF. That is the thing. That's all. आगे चलें. कोई मुश्किल बात तो नहीं है. What is saying? अगर दो Cisco device है, fine. You are running frame relay between them. Which encapsulation is by default used? Cisco encapsulation. Cisco frame relay encapsulation. But is saying if you are using two different devices, one is Cisco, other is non-Cisco, then which encapsulation you have to run? IETF. Fine. Next thing. Frame relay operates using as opposed to the physical circuit that leased lines use. As opposed. भाई मैं ये physical circuit नहीं use करता. These virtual circuits won't link together the thousands of devices connected to the provider cloud. Frame relay. Read this. बहुत मारूंगा. मजाक पता है आपको बहुत बार. ऐसा नहीं करना होता. मैं जाता हूँ कोई चीज रहने चाहिए. यस आप जो क्वेश्चन पूछ रहे थे पढ़ो अभी. यस यस फाइन फटाफट. पढ़ो आगे. आपने क्वेश्चन पूछा था ना हमें अपनी डेंसिटी का पता कैसे चलता है विद द हेल्प ऑफ इनवर्स आर. इन नॉर्मल स्विच सिनेरियोस व्हाट थिंग इज वर्किंग आर. हियर व्हाट थिंग इज वर्किंग वी विल डिस्कस हाउ इनवर्स आर विल वर्क. वेट फर्स्ट रीड दिस पैराग्राफ. Inverse RP is used to map known DELCI to the okay. This paragraph. मन में पढ़ लो भाई अपने फटाफट पढ़ लो. पढ़ लिया भाई फटाफट पढ़ो यार. टेलीकम्युनिकेशन जो सर्विस प्रोवाइड कर रहा है इस टेलको. चलती है LMI के बारे में पढ़ो फिर डिस्कस करते हैं. ये बात वही थी जो मैंने अभी आपको बताई थी जो अभी आपने पढ़ी है दैट हाउ ट्रैफिक इज ट्रांसफर्ड. अगेन आई कैन रिपीट इफ यू वांट. दिस इज आर वन. यस यार लोकली सिग्निफिकेंट का मतलब उसने कहा कि आर वन के लिए डेल्सी लोकली सिग्निफिकेंट है. यार मैं तेरे को क्या कह रहा था, ये बात मैं कहना चाहता था, यहाँ तू सेम डेलसी नहीं यूज कर सकता, इट इज नॉट पॉसिबल. हाँ वो स्विच नहीं कर पाएगा वरना ट्रैफिक को कभी भी. यार ये बंदा मैपिंग कैसे करेगा? आप वो इस वजह से बोल रहा है क्योंकि वो इसका भी क्राइटेरिया बीच में नहीं रख रहा. वो ये नहीं सोच रहा कि इस बंदे को फर्क पड़ रहा है या नहीं पड़ रहा. आप मैपिंग बना ही नहीं पाओगे यार, बना के देख लेना रियल टाइम में. यार खुद सोचना, एक प्रोवाइडर है, वो दो बंदों को सेम डेलसी अगर यूज करने देगा तो क्या इशू आएगा? वो स्विच कैसे करेगा उनके ट्रैफिक को? अगर वो तीन बंदों को सेम डेलसी दे देगा, दे दी तो जब ट्रैफिक आया, वही मैं सेम एग्जांपल ले रहा हूं, R1 R2 और R3, दिस पर्सन विल नेवर चेक योर IP, ही विल ऑलवेज चेक योर डेलसी. उसने यही बोला ना, सर्विस प्रोवाइडर विल रिसीव योर ट्रैफिक, वो देखेगा फ्रेम रेल हेडर में किसको, डेलसी को. ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ डेलसी ही विल स्विच योर ट्रैफिक. अगर इफ यू यूज ऑन द थ्री इंटरफेसेस 102, नाउ यहां से आया यहां जाना चाहता है, भाई किस तरफ जाना चाहता है, कैसे पता चलेगा?
सर अगर दो में आईपी यूज करें सेम, सर वो अगर एक तरफ से आता है तो वो रिडम नहीं कर देगा अगर 102
है? यार वही तो प्रॉब्लम है, वही तो मैं इस भाई को समझाना चाहता हूं. तीन का एग्जांपल लेके, लोकली सिग्निफिकेंट का मतलब है कि R1 जाने के लिए सिर्फ क्या देखता है, डेलसी. द थिंग इज सेइंग लोकली सिग्निफिकेंट इज जस्ट मींस दैट इफ सी on R1 there will be a mapping for R2 and R3, yes or no? And there will be no mapping for R1 on itself, yes or no? So R1 cannot ping itself. Whenever a router want to send traffic on a frame relay interface, always it will check IP2. If router is not able to find a IP, router will never able to ping. This thing is clear? यार डेलसी आपको खरीदनी पड़ेगी, घर जाके दोबारा पढ़ लियो उस चीज को, कल पूछ लियो. रीड अबाउट LMI. सर्विस प्रोवाइडर में एक ही राउटर होगा?
नहीं मतलब, अच्छा उसके अंदर का बात हो रहा
है. हाँ एक मिनट हो गया यार, मैं ही समझाता हूँ. आ गया ना, बस यही कहानी खत्म कर दी. दिस इज प्रोवाइडर, योर साइट इज कनेक्टेड हेयर, you will be connected to one router. There will be many more routers also. This is connected to site B. This is connected to site 3. What is trying to say? LMI will work between your router and frame relay switch. Actually, frame relay switch is also a router on which IP routing is disabled and frame relay switching is enabled. Fine. Now try to understand a simple thing. What is the use of LMI? Dekho, by default LMI is used to know your PVC status. Isliye use hota PVC status janne ke. Dekho, now you have defined that if you want to reach, okay, first of all we will discuss about inverse arc, how inverse arc will work. Fine. Okay, first thing, frame relay is basically divided into two parts. Frame relay interfaces, the interfaces on which you are running frame relay can be divided into two parts. One is point to point, other one is point to material. On point to point interfaces, do we need arc? No. So in the similar way, on point-to-point frame relay interfaces, there is no need of inverse R. Fine? Because there is only one other end. There is no need of inverse R. But when I talk about frame relay point-to-multipoint interfaces, there is a need of inverse R. This thing is clear? Second thing. Let's say R1 want to reach R2. So here I am taking example that del C's are defined here to this interface of frame relay switch. We have marked two del C, 102, 103. This is 201, this is 30. First thing, R1 will send a signal to frame relay switch. If inverse ARP is on, and inverse ARP is only on in which case? When you are using which interface? Point to multipoint. R1 will send a signal to frame relay switch. Please tell me the del C associated with my interface. Please tell me the del C is associated with my interface. Now, frame relay switch will tell him that your del C's are 102 and 103. Now, what this guy will do? This guy will put these del C's in the source and it will generate a frame relay inverse R. Now, when it will generate a frame relay inverse R, it will be received by this switch again. Now, this switch will check. 102 is connected to, because it is having a mapping that when I am receiving something on 102, I have sent it out to 201. He will send it out to 201. Bhai, sona nahi hai. When it will receive something on? It has to send it out on 301. Now, when R2 will receive the R from R1, it will get to know that I have to use 201 when I have to reach 10001. Yes or no? Okay, how? Because when R1 will send the inverse R, source will be 10001. Del C will be 102. It will be received by the provider. Provider will send this R2 201. Now R is received. Now R2 will get to know that if I want to read 10001, I have to use del C. Now R2 will reply for this inverse R. Fine. R will inverse R reply will be received by provider. What provider will do? Provider will send 2012. 102. Now R1 will check. When he has generated an ARP for the del C 102, who has replied? 10001. Who has replied? Yes or no? So he will make an entry in its table that if I want to reach 10002, which del C I have to use? Similar with the case with R3. That if I have to reach 10003, I have to use which del C? Similar is the case with R3, that if it has to reach 10001, which del C it has to use? 30. In this case, inverse R, like this inverse R will work. This thing is clear. Second thing, this is dynamic mapping. This is dynamic mapping. When dynamic mapping is there, FR network will work like a broadcast network. Will work like a? What do you mean by broadcast network? Broadcast network doesn't mean that if R1 is generating an inverse R, it will go throughout the network. It just means that on this frame relay network, if R1 is sending a broadcast, that is allowed. If R1 is sending a broadcast, that is allowed. Let's say R1, this is FRS, this is R2. Fine. This is LAN of R1, this is LAN of R2. This is A, this is B. Now, you have this IP to this IP connectivity, yes or no? And you are running which mapping? Dynamic mapping. Dynamic mapping means mapping is formed by inverse R. Mapping is formed by, this thing is clear? Now, R1 will send, let's think like we are running RIP between these two routers. I am running RIP version 2. R1 will send a multicast update. So R1 will be able to send multicast update on this particular link, because this link is acting as a broadcast link, not as a non-broadcast link. This thing is clear? I am explaining it again. When I have a dynamic mapping, inverse ARP is on, or you can say when inverse ARP is on and when we have dynamic mapping, NBMA network no more exists. Which network exists? Broadcast. That on these particular links, multicast and broadcast will travel. There will be no issue. But if I am configuring static mapping, static mapping, what you can do? It is your wish. You want to enable broadcast or you want to disable broadcast. And by default, broadcasts are always disabled.
So
dynamic mapping mein routing protocol use kar sakte ho. Dynamic mapping mein routing, static mein bhi kar sakte ho. Par ve kuch aur. Fine? So this thing is clear, Sanjay?
ये डायग्राम है, ये मैपिंग हुई है मेरी इनवर्स आर्क की, अगर ये आईपी एड्रेस बाय डिफॉल्ट कभी चेंज हो जाता है किसी का कोई कर देता तो ये मैपिंग डिस्कनेक्ट हो जाएगी ना?
आपको क्लियर करनी पड़ेगी मैन्युअली, यू हैव टू क्लियर दिस मैपिंग मैन्युअली. फाइन, अदरवाइज द एलएमआई वर्किंग बिटवीन आर1 एंड फ्रेमलेस स्विच विल ऑलवेज चेक दैट दिस मैपिंग इज फाइन और फाइन. Now guys, there are three states for the PVC. One is everything is up and routers can exchange. One is okay. R1 this is, FRS this is R2. You will find inactive state only when from R1 perspective all things are fine, but there is some problem. You will find deleted state when there is some mapping problem. Fine. So that's all for frame relay, just the basic parts. Fine. Next thing, how many types of FR topology exist? They are basically of two types. One is second is, what do you mean by partial mesh and what do you mean by full mesh? Partial mesh means this is FRS, this is R2, this is R3. See here, R1 is connected to R2, R2 is connected to R1 is connected to R3 is connected to. This particular topology is called partial mesh. And in full mesh, R2 will be connected to R3 will be connected to. This thing is clear? The difference between full mesh and, you can leave this thing. See, नहीं यार. Yes, partial mesh is also called hub and spoke. What do we call partial mesh? Hub and spoke. ये नहीं पढ़ना आपको. ये तीन चीजें नहीं पढ़नी है आपको. छोड़ सकते हो आप इसको. एंड ये पढ़ेंगे हम, कल पढ़ेंगे यार, प्रैक्टिकल कल करेंगे इसका. ठीक है जी, कोई प्रॉब्लम हो तो कल देखेंगे इसको.